الحمد لله الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا في كتاب الله يوم خلق السماوات والأرض منها أربعة حرم. صدق الله العظيم. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the world, and peace and blessings be upon his prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, the head of all messengers, upon his family and all his companions. Today is 30 of Dhul-Qa'dah, and tomorrow the month of Dhul-Hijjah is going to start. Our Eid al-Adha also is depend upon our Islamic month. So 10 of Dhul-Hijjah is our Eid al-Adha. Inshallah ta'ala, it will come according to this year, 12th of August on Monday. So from tomorrow, the month of Dhul-Hijjah is going to start. What ahkam Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave in this month? If we reflect upon Quran and Sunnah, then we can know there are 10 ahkam Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave in this month. How many ahkam? 10 ahkam, 10 orders, commandments Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave in this month. Number one, Hajj. Hajj we can perform only in this month. We cannot perform Hajj in any other month. And number two is Qurbani. Qurbani we can make only in this month. We cannot make Qurbani after this month or before this month. And number three, Eid al-Adha. Eid al-Adha will come only in this month of Dhul-Hijjah. And Eid al-Adha, Salah, also we can read only in this month. Then number four, Takbirat-e-Tashriq. Takbirat-e-Tashriq also we recite only in this month. We cannot read the Takbirat-e-Tashriq after every Salah before this month or after this month. Only in this month and only in 5 days. Not more than 5 days also. And number six, the fast. Number five, the fast of Ashra-e Dhul-Hijjah. This is also a special reward for the first 9 days of Dhul-Hijjah. This reward also we will get only in this month. And number six, the fast of Arafah. The day of Arafah also will come only in the month of Dhul-Hijjah. Then number seven, to fast is haram in 4 days only in this month. 4 days will come in this month. Then number eight, the virtue of the 10th night. Does virtue, the fazilat only in this month, in these 9 nights of Dhul-Hijjah, 10 nights of Dhul-Hijjah. Then number nine, do not cut hair and nails. Does hukmah and order also come only in this month of Dhul-Hijjah? And number ten, we must abstain ourselves from guna. So there are 10 ahkam Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave in this month of Dhul-Hijjah. So number one, we mention about Hajj. So Hajj last, before we mention about Hajj, Hajj is first for whom and what is about Hajj we mention. So today, and number two, Hukmah is Qurbani. Number two is Qurbani. Qurbani is wajib. Every adult Muslim male or female who owns 612.36 grams of silver, or its equivalent in money, today's money, 4,984 rand. 4,984 rand. A person who have this money, then qurbani is wajib for him. Or personal ornaments, stock in trade, or any other form of wealth which is surplus extra to his basic needs is under an obligation to offer qurbani. Then qurbani is wajib for him. And it is written in Masail-e Raf'at. Mufti Raf'at Sahab wrote in the kitab, who is from Darul Ulum Deoband, who is teaching in Darul Ulum Deoband Madrasa. He says, a person who does not have 4,984 in cash, but he has different extra thing in his house. For example, a person who has television, TV, or radio, or more than 3 clothes, or more than 2 shoes, and that money will be 4,884. Then also qurbani is wajib for him. So many people, they must understand, they think zakat is wajib upon whom, qurbani also wajib upon him. So if zakat is not first for me, so sadaqatul fitr also is not first for me, and qurbani also is not first for me. Sadaqatul fitr is wajib for person for whom, qurbani also is wajib for whom, for that same person. A person who has 4,984 rand, he has cash money. Even he has that money in 3 days of qurbani, 10 of Dhul Hijjah, 11 of Dhul Hijjah, or 12 of Dhul Hijjah. Even he will get that money, 12 of Dhul Hijjah, before sunset. Maybe someone, any generous person come and he give 5,000 rand as a gift. Then also qurbani is wajib for that person. So qurbani is wajib. Then, what is the virtue of qurbani? The hadith of Tirmidhi Sharif. قال أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا رسول الله ما هذه الأضاحي؟ قال سنة أبيكم إبراهيم عليه الصلاة والسلام. قالوا فما لنا فيها يا رسول الله؟ قال بكل شعرة حسنة. قال فالصوف يا رسول الله؟ قال بِالصُّوفِ حَسَنَةً. What Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a person, what is qurbani? Sahaba ikram asked Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is the qurbani? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned qurbani is the sunnah of your father Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. And then Sahaba asked, O Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what will we get in this qurbani? What benefit we will get in this qurbani? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, بِكُلِّ شَعْرَةٍ حَسَنَةٍ. You will get reward for every hair. If you want to count the hair of goat or wool of sheep, you cannot count from morning till evening. Also, if you will count, you will not be able to count. We cannot count our hair. How we can count animals' hair? So that reward we will get. Even qurbani is not wajib. Then also a person who have interest and shock to get the reward, then also this person will make qurbani. So this is qurbani. Then number 3, Eid al-Adha Salah. Eid al-Adha come only in this month, in the month of Dhul Hijjah. And the day of Eid al-Adha, the day of servants' invitation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this day also come only in this month, in the month of Dhul Hijjah. Number 1, we mentioned Hajj, it come only in this month. Number 2, Qurbani. Number 3, Eid al-Adha only come in this month. And number 4, Takbirat-e-Tashriq is wajib after every Fard Salah from 9th of Dhul Hijjah till 13th of Dhul, from 9th of Dhul Hijjah from Fajr till 13th of Dhul Hijjah Asr Salah. After Asr also we must read last. So in total 23 Salah. How many salah? 23. 9 of Dhul Hijjah, 5 salah. 10 of Dhul Hijjah, 5 salah. 11 of Dhul Hijjah, 5 salah. So 15. And 12 of Dhul Hijjah, 5 salah. 20. And 13 of Dhul Hijjah, Fajr, Zuhar, and Asr. So 23 salah. We must read aloud. That is wajib. To read aloud also wajib, and to read also is wajib. And for women, they must read soft. But today, we read like women. So we should try to read aloud the takbirat al-tashriq. Read once again, whoever don't know, they also can know. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. So that takbirat al-tashriq also come only in this month, in the month of Dhul Hijjah. Number 5, the fast of Ashra-e Dhul Hijjah. The special reward we will get if we will fast in these 9 days of Dhul Hijjah. What reward we will get? The hadith of Tirmidhi Sharif, Ya'dilu siyamu kulli yawmin minha bi siyami sana. A person who will fast in the 9 days of Dhul Hijjah, he will get 1 year fast reward. 1 year fast reward. For tomorrow, the first book of Dhul Hijjah. A person who will fast tomorrow, he will get 1 year reward. If he will fast again Sunday, he will get again 1 year reward. And till 9 of Dhul Hijjah, a person who will fast, he will get 9 years fast reward. How easy to get this reward? We will get only in this month. The special reward we can get in this month, in the month of Dhul Hijjah. Then the fast of Arafah, number 6. The fast of Arafah also will come only in this month. Only in this month of Dhul Hijjah. A person who will fast on the day of Arafah. What is the day of Arafah? Before the one day of Eid al-Adha, 9th of Dhul Hijjah. 9th of Dhul Hijjah, according to English year, according to this year, is 11th of August. A person who will fast, 11th of August on Sunday, a person who will fast, he will get 1 year reward and extra what? صيام يوم عرفة أحتسب على الله أن يكفر السنة التي قبله والسنة التي بعده. الله تبارك وتعالى will forgive his previous minus son also and coming year sons also. الله تبارك وتعالى forgive. That is special reward we will get. And this nukta every year we mention. A person, Allah the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم said, a person his previous who will pass his previous year's son also will be forgiven, and coming year's son also will be forgiven. So he will pass, it means he will get 1 year more life. Then he can commit son. If he will alive, he will die. How he can commit son? So he will be alive, then he will commit son. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will forgive. But it is not necessary. I don't know, Uncle Hashim and Uncle Faisal fasted last year. He fasted. So it happened also. So we don't know. But does it nukta ulama mentioned? So he fasted also, he passed away. But ulama wrote, maybe a person who will get tawfiq, he should try to fast the day of Arafah. Then number 7, to fast is haram in 5 days in a year. How many days? 5 years in a year to haram. Jay? 5 years. So, five days. To fast 5 days in a year is haram. So number 1 is 8th of Dhul Hijjah. That one is coming in this month. 8th of Dhul Hijjah, 9th of Dhul Hijjah, 10th of Dhul Hijjah, 11th of Dhul Hijjah, 12th of Dhul Hijjah, and 13th of Dhul Hijjah. You understand? Eid al-Adha day. And then after 11 of Dhul Hijjah, 12 of Dhul Hijjah, and 13 of Dhul Hijjah. Those 4 days come in this month. And the day of Eid al-Fitr. That is 5 days. To fast also is haram. A person who said, no, I want to fast. No, he can't fast. Even he will fast, it means he is committing haram work. So those 4 days will come in this month of Dhul Hijjah. Then number 8, the virtue of the 10 nights. The virtue of the 10 nights also will come only in this month of Dhul Hijjah. Quran mentioned wal fajr, then wal layal al ash. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is taking an oath wal layal al ash by the 10 nights. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is taking oath. Why? Because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is showing here that the very important night coming now. So in this night, if a person who will make ibadah, he will get reward like Laylatul Qadr. Hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, وَقِيَامُ لَيْلَةٍ مِنْ ذِي الْحِجَّةِ بقيام ليلة القدر. A person who will fast in this 10 nights of the Hijjah, وقيام كل ليلة منها بقيام ليلة القدر, he will get reward like ليلة القدر. In the month of Ramadan, we don't know in which night there is ليلة القدر. We will get or not, we don't know. But here, the Sahih Hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, you will get definitely this reward, like Laylatul Qadr. But problem, you know, so many things we follow like our reward, our custom. In which day there is reward, all people will make ibadah. And when there is no reward, no custom, people don't make ibadah. Like 14th of Shaban, all people know it's a great night, big night. Everybody will make ibadah. But this night, also great night, we will get reward like Laylatul Qadr, but we don't worry about it. So we should try to make ibadah in these 10 nights of Dhul Hijjah also. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq to make amal. Then number 9, walayal in ash, the virtue of 10 nights in the number 9, suggested these for these days. Okay, we must not cut our nails and hair. This one also, this hukma come only in this month of Dhul Hijjah. We cannot get this hukma in order in other months. What Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, the hadith of Muslim Sharif, عن أم سلمة رضي الله تعالى عنها أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا رأيتم هلال ذي الحجة وأراد أحدكم أن يضحي فليمسك عن شعره وأظفاره. The hadith of Muslim Sharif. Hazrat Umm Salma radiallahu ta'ala anha narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, any one of you sides the moon of the Hijjah, and any one of you intend to offer sacrifice, he should not cut his nail and hair. Here, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, fal yumsik. Here, lam came. Lam means chahiye. Use nahi kaatna chahiye. Fal yom se, he should not cut. It means, does it not wajib, does it mustahab? So if we will make amal, inshallah, we will get reward. But a person who will cut his hair or nail, then we can't give tana. Hey, you don't know Dhul Hijjah is started and you are cutting your hair. No, we can't do like that, because does it not wajib? Wajib, if there is wajib, then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, fala yaqrubanna musallana. Qurbani is wajib if you are rich. If you are not making qurbani, do not come near my Eidga also. فَلَا يَقْرُبَنَّ مُسَلَّانَ. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is shouting. فَلَا يَقْرُبَنَّ مُسَلَّانَ. You don't come near our Eidga also. So it means that what is showing wajib. And here, فَلْيُمْسِكْ لَمْكَمْ. It means should. A person, whoever, now today is last day, from tomorrow, today if we want to cut our hair or nails, we should cut. But tomorrow, we should abstain to cut. But a person who will cut, we cannot give tana. And number 10, we should abstain ourselves from all kind of guna in these days. In the days of Dhul Hijjah, this is great days came. So we mentioned 10 ahkam. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave, we can know that ahkam from Quran and Sunnah. 10 ahkam only we can get in this month of Dhul Hijjah. Number 1, Hajj, we can perform only in this month. Number 2, Qurbani. Number 3, Idul Adha, come only in this month. Number 4, Takbirat al-Tashriq, we mention now, come only in this month. Number 5, the fast of Ashara Dhul Hijjah, the special reward 1 year. fast reward we will get only in this month. Number 6, the fast of Arafah, we will get only in this month of Dhul Hijjah, which one is going to start from tomorrow. And number 7, to fast is haram in 5 days, so 4 days coming in this month of Dhul Hijjah. Do not cut your nails and hair. That hukm also come only in this month. And number 10, ulama suggested from Quran and Hadith, they understood and they said that it's great day, so we should protect ourselves from all kind of guna. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant me also topic to make amal, grant you also topic to make amal. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.